CBS 6 News starts now.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Jack Lamson.
And I'm Julia Dunn. We are under a weather alert day as widespread snow falls all across the capital region. Showing you a time lapse from Schenectady. This is from our Fraunhofer SkyCam network. This was yesterday, the first snow coming in around noontime, bringing several inches in just a few hours. Alyssa's saying probably over a foot at this point.
It came fast and quick. Yeah, this morning we have team coverage for you. Melissa Lee and Leanne Rosa are keeping an eye on messy road conditions.
Now we have Craig Gold, who was also live out in the elements this morning. First, though, we want to kick things off with meteorologist Alyssa Karapries with more on this storm. And Alyssa, I mean, we're kind of in the thick of things right now. It's not going to be tapering off anytime soon.
Yeah, that's the thing that I want to stress this morning. We are in the middle of this storm. It is far from over. So if you are waking up this morning and thinking, man, we picked up a lot of snow, it's got to be winding down soon. That is not the case. Look at the radar showing widespread snow at this hour, and it's become a little more widespread recently, filling in around the capital region and locations south. With that being said, let's get right over to Melissa and check in on road conditions. Melissa, what are you seeing out there?
Yeah, of course. So all of this weather is, causing us to have some team coverage this morning, keeping an eye on the roadways for you. You can see Leanne DeRosa. She's going to be joining us here in just a minute. Right now, we want to take a look at our traffic authority map, where we are seeing plenty of snow-covered roads, but also an accident this morning out along 88. This is in Duanesburg. Now we want to send it out to Leanne DeRosa, who you just saw. She is inside the CBS 6 Mobile Weather Authority powered by Mohawk Honda, cruising on the Northway this morning. Leanne, I mean, if you had to guess, how many plows have you seen so far?
Oh, I lost count because I saw a lot of just private companies plowing the side streets as well, but we saw a line of them, the DOT, out on the Northway. Now we got off, we just pulled into Saratoga Springs, and I want to show you the difference in these roads. These side streets are a lot messier. More snow covered for sure. But again, the County Highway Department is out working on these streets. This is Broadway. We're just coming up to the Adelphi Hotel. So just plan accordingly this morning and take it slow. Back to you guys.
I saw that Jeep on my way into work this morning. All right, 5:35, our team coverage continues with meteorologist Craig Gold. He's joining us live in Latham this morning.
So clearly it's still snowing out here. It's not snowing as heavy as it was obviously last night, so we're not seeing those rates of 1 to 2 inches an hour. But I would not be lulled into a sense of security in regards to this storm because we're not done with it just yet. We're at the Latham Circle. That's where, of course, Route 9 meets Troy Schenectady Road. And they've done a fairly decent job of plowing the roads. But here's the thing. Leanne was talking about this before. Just because you could see the road down to the pavement does not mean that it's not slick.
Yeah, we'll have another update coming for you in just a little bit. Back to you guys in the studio.
All right, Craig, thanks. The massive snowfall is affecting state government this morning. Governor Cuomo says all non-essential state employees in 11 capital region counties will not report to work today. The governor's also activated the Emergency Operations Center and put the National Guard on standby. It's causing hundreds of closures as well this morning, not just schools. You can find them scrolling at the bottom of your screen. Some of the major districts, though, Albany, Troy, Schenectady, those are closed. So, too, is Saratoga Springs and Pittsfield. For a full list, if you don't want to wait for it to scroll across the screen, you can visit cbs6albany.com. Power outages as well this morning. As of right now, things are a little bit better out there. You're looking at about 150 customers without power in the Montgomery County area, kind of spread out around there. Restoration time expected around 7 o'clock, but we know how those can change. We'll keep an eye on that for you and let you know what we're able to find out.